Are QPR defensively good enough to beat the drop? That's what we're exploring with both Jawad and Jack on this QPR view this week. How are you both?
Yeah, really good, Mark. How are you doing?
Yeah, good. Thank you, Jawad.
Yeah, I'm good. Really good.
Cool. So let's talk about the Norwich game first, and then we'll look ahead to the game at Bristol City. It's a huge week for QPR, isn't it, this one? Obviously, a big game on Wednesday, which by the time this video goes out will have been played. We'll talk about that briefly. But let's review the Norwich game. Jared, what was your view of the goals you have scored, first of all?
It was actually a really good Championship game, actually. Two teams wanting to win it. I think Norwich, on paper, a really, really strong team. I think a better manager would get more out of them. And yeah, I thought first half we had the best of it. The second half, they came back into it. And I think QPR of old would have lost that game 3-1. But with the mentality in the squad now, the manager and the options on the bench, I think, a 2-1 down, definitely we would have lost that game in years gone by. But they did well to come back, I thought.
Somebody commented that Frey, the position that Frey was in for the goal, no other striker that you've got in the club would have been in that same position. So it's nice to have a forward that knows where that ball's going to go. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I commented on that actually, and it's true. The amount of crosses that go in, and Dykes is caught on his heels. Armstrong still learning how to be a striker. At this level, it was just a goal that we don't really score that often. So hopefully we can see more of that in the coming games.
Yeah, I knew I'd read it somewhere. It was your Twitter, wasn't it?
It was.
Which you can follow Jared and Jack on their Twitter accounts in the description below. All right, Jack, I'm going to ask you to come and talk me through the Norwich goals then. And from your point of view, what went wrong?
I mean, I think defensively it's quite, I feel like we give away a lot of goals, silly goals, we have done all season, and I mean, like Jared said, you know, we're against a team that actually on paper's got serious quality. I think Sargent really kind of shone for them actually up front. So in terms of like the goals, it's just typical as well that, you know, 1-0 up at half time, feeling good, you know, things are actually kind of working. And, you know, I remember I was fortunate I had to go to hospital to see a family member, but I was, you know, obviously checking my phone, got half time, 1-0, thought, oh yeah, brilliant. I'll just quickly check it in a second. 2-1 down, I was like, right, okay. But yeah, absolutely. I think us coming back and having that mentality is, you know, regardless of if we do go down a couple of goals now, we're more than likely to put a better shift in than we would have done, you know, 2 months ago.
Yeah, and how much is it good to see the new boys kind of combining to get the point there? Do you think now that you've got options coming off the bench that are going to allow you to catch Huddersfield or free falling Stoke?
Our rotation that we've got available now is so much better, and Anderson as well, like that ball into Frey is just, we haven't seen a player do that for us, I think, for a long time. You know, a lot of our kind of balls in to Dykes or, you know, Sinclair, it's pretty much the same thing over and over really until it kind of works. So it's nice to kind of see people bringing a bit more to the team. It's a bit different, but also the urgency as well. You know, you look at Hayden, you look at Colback, you know, he's, I think these guys are going to be so pivotal for us for these last couple of games. And you can see as well around the stands as well, if you watch the second goal, you know, it goes out for a throw and you've got one of our fans grabbing the ball, chucking it to Smith, you know, and it's that sense of urgency, you know, everyone's behind the team, I think. So it's so nice and refreshing to actually see and feel that again at Loftus Road.
Was Hayden your man of the match, Jared?
Yeah, he controlled the game, really. He didn't really move out of like a 50 by 50 box almost, but he completely ran the game. His passing was concise, was firm. Some of the players actually struggled to control the passes because they're not used to somebody passing with urgency, accuracy. Yeah, he kind of hobbled off in the 86th minute, I think it was. So hopefully he's fit for Wednesday night, because it just shows the kind of player that we'll be missing in there. And it actually gave Colback a bit more freedom to kind of go and do what he does, which is tear around the pitch, yeah, knowing that there's somebody behind him as well. Okay. Yeah.
All right, then. So Stoke away, Bristol City away, Rotherham at home before having to go to Leicester. So this is these next three games are going to make or break your season, aren't they? Looking at the back line, as we said at the start of this video, and the goalkeeper position, let's just review whether or not you feel that they are the five that started against Norwich are the five that you would go with then for this run in. Start with the goalkeeper. Begovic, not put a foot wrong recently.
There's nothing else behind him, really. I think Begovic starts. That's it, no matter how poor his form is. I've just seen, though, since the manager came in, the XG against is the best in the league, which shows we're not giving away many chances. Yeah. But like Jack said, the simplicity of that Norwich goal at the weekend, that first one was infuriating, because they go in at half time, and I think it's moments like that cost us. But the keeper, there's no one beyond him, really.
Okay, and Jack, Cook and Clark Salter, impressive pairing.
I think he's one of the best centre backs in the league at the moment. And it's so nice to actually see him at his best, you know, when he is fully fixed. I know he's had his injuries are quite prolific, but having Cook as well for him must be great, you know, to have someone with that experience, that type of mentorship. And, you know, once we've got that steady at the back kind of foundation, that's where we're really going to see, I think, the best out of the, you know, the midfielders that we brought in.
Okay.
I'm a big fan, big fan.
Okay, and Jawad, I'll leave you to do the left back and the right back then. So Cannon and Powell.
I would probably argue that the drop off, if Cannon got injured, the drop off from him to the next one behind is the biggest in a squad. If the manager could probably pick one player not to get injured, would probably think it's Cannon. And I'm a bit on the fence with him, but the drop off to the next fullback is huge. And I would say if the manager could keep four players fit for the rest of the season, five players fit, it would be the keeper and that back four that played at the weekend, because the drop-off in quality to what's on the bench is probably the biggest in the whole squad now.
Okay, so let's answer our question at the start then. Is this back five good enough to keep you up? Jack?
100%, yeah. I think I've got it.
Jared?
Yeah, if the back five stay fit, I think we've got a very good chance of staying up this season.
All right, well, wish you luck against Stoke. Let's just get your predictions for the Bristol City game this weekend. Jawad, obviously you've got your background set up to wind up any Bristol City fans watching this. What do you make of your trip to Ashton Gate? Obviously, it's a tricky one. What do you go with score prediction was?
I think with the Huddersfield and Blackburn game, getting 4 points from those was a good return. I think with the point against Norwich, if they can pick up 3 points in the week, and again, 4 points is a great return. I think if they do win in the week, I think a point at Bristol City would be an excellent result. Our record there has been pretty good over the last couple of years, but I think to be realistic, with the Rotherham game coming up as well, I think a point would be a good result for us.
Yeah. Jack?
Yeah, for the Bristol game?
Yeah.
Bristol, yeah, I think we'll win 2-0. I think we've got to use, you know, the players know Rob Dickey, and as much as, you know, I'm grateful for everything he's done for the club, he's not the quickest, and I think we should probably try and exploit that.
Okay. All right, well, wish you luck for what's going to be a very, very busy week for QPR, and we'll catch you both next week to review it all. Cheers, thank you very much.
Thanks. Thanks, Mark.